I'd like to welcome you all here today, those of you who are joining us from your own homes. Know that Christ is here. Whenever we celebrate the Eucharist, proclaiming the Lord's death until he comes again, we never do so alone. You are joined with us in this Eucharist, in bringing the offering of your lives and your hearts. We celebrate together with and on behalf of all of you. Our first hymn is How Great Thou Art.
Thank you.
God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Jesus says, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is close at hand." So let us turn away from sin and turn to Christ, confessing our sins in penitence and faith. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins, for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name.
Amen.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, whose blessed Son was revealed to destroy the works of the devil, and to make us the children of God and heirs of eternal life, grant that we, having this hope, may purify ourselves even as he is pure, that when he shall appear in power and great glory, we may be made like him in his eternal and glorious kingdom, where he is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
For it is as if a man, going on a journey, summoned his slaves and entrusted his property to them. To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, to another 1, to each according to his ability. Then he went away. The one who had received the 5 talents went off at once and traded with them and made 5 more talents. In the same way, the one who had received 2 talents made 2 more talents, but the one who had received the 1 talent went off and dug a hole in the ground and hid his master's money. After a long time, the master of those slaves came home and settled accounts with them. Then the one who had received the 5 talents came forward, bringing 5 more talents, saying, Master, you handed over to me 5 talents. See, I have made 5 more talents. His master said to him, Well done, good and trustworthy slave. You have been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master. And the one with the 2 talents also came forward, saying, Master, you handed over to me 2 talents. See, I have made 2 more talents. His master said to him, Well done, good and faithful servant. You have been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master. Then the one who had received the 1 talent also came forward, saying, Master, I knew that you were a harsh man, reaping where you did not sow, and gathering where you did not scatter seed. So I was afraid, and I went and hid your talent in the ground. Here, you have what is yours. But his master replied, You wicked and lazy slave! You knew, did you, that I reap where I did not sow, and gather where I did not scatter? Then you ought to have invested my money with the bankers, and on my return I would have received what was my own with interest. So take the talent from him, and give it to the one with 10 talents. For to all those who have, more will be given, and they will have an abundance. But from those who have nothing, even what they have will be taken away. As for this worthless slave, throw him out into the outer darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
I have to admit to finding this week's reading a little difficult. With weeping and gnashing of teeth, this is not gentle Jesus, meek and mild. There are some hard messages in these parables at the end of Matthew. This is set at a time when Jesus knows he is approaching the end of his ministry on earth. It is not a time for mincing words. It is more about calling a spade, to ensure that the disciples have got the message. Money talks, and on the face of it, this story is all, show me the money. The master has given his servants a pot of money each, and this isn't just a bit of pocket money to tide them over while he's gone. Oh no, for a talent was worth more than 15 years worth of wages for a labourer. So this is one rich and generous master. If I translate that to today's terms, the servant with 1 talent would have been given, of order, £400,000. And the one who had 5 talents, almost £2 million. So this isn't just about money. It's about trust too. But it is more than that. It's about respect and relationship. For the servants will have seen how the master works and will know what he expects. Now, if we go back to the beginning of the text, there isn't a great deal of explanation about what the master expects, but he entrusts his property to them, each according to his ability. Now, when he returns, the master is delighted with the first 2 servants, for they have done as he had hoped. They have followed his example. They have lived in relationship, and they've doubled his money. But they have also been true to themselves, each according to his ability. He praises them. He rewards them richly by putting them in charge of many more things. And he welcomes them into his joy. Now, in contrast, the third servant is sort of picking a fight to cover up his failings and saying that he was afraid. Now, fear can be a great preventer, and he absolutely knows that he has not done the right thing. He also says he knows that the master is capable of harsh judgment. But this is news to us. The master we have seen goes above and beyond. He is generous. Now, if we consider other pieces of scripture, from Isaiah to Matthew and to Luke, the message of God is always, do not be afraid. The master in this parable gave all the servants a great treasure and an amazing opportunity. The first two servants took that opportunity, and in doing so, they also took a risk. If they had not trusted the master, could they have been so bold? Could they have taken that risk? They did have the relationship, and they knew their master would not punish them for every little mistake. So they were free to act in confidence in both themselves and their master. Now, the third servant, he acted in fear. He showed no affection for his master, and he was concerned only for his own ends. Because of his own timidness and selfishness, he failed to harness the opportunity given to him, and even that which he had been given was taken away from him. So what does this parable tell us? Firstly, it's really not all about the money, and it never has been. It's about recognizing the valuable and generous gifts that God has given us and doing something about them with confidence and not being paralyzed by fear. For our God is loving and generous, but we are to remember that we are also accountable to him for the use of those gifts. It is about using our opportunities, about removing the bushel, to place our light upon the stand and let it shine to glorify our Father in heaven. Amen.
We have our next hymn, Be Still for the Presence of the Lord.
Thank you.
us profess our faith in the words of the Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father.
United in the company of all the faithful and looking for the coming of the kingdom, let us offer our prayers to God, the source of all life and holiness. Merciful Lord, strengthen all Christian people by your Holy Spirit, that we may live as a royal priesthood and a holy nation, to the praise of Jesus Christ, our Saviour. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless John, our bishop, and Martin, Bishop of Dudley, and all ministers of your church, that by faithful proclamation of your word, we may be built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets into a holy temple in the Lord. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Empower us by the gift of your holy and life-giving Spirit, that we may be transformed into the likeness of Christ, from glory to glory. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give to the world and its peoples the peace that comes from above, that they may find Christ's way of freedom and life. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Hold in your embrace all who witness to your love in the service of the poor and needy, all who minister to the sick and dying, and all who bring light to those in darkness. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Touch and heal all those whose lives are scarred by sin or disfigured by pain, that raised from death to life in Christ, their sorrow may be turned to eternal joy. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Remember, in your mercy, all those gone before us, who have been well pleasing to you from eternity. Preserve in your faith your servants on earth. Guide us to your kingdom, and grant us your peace at all times. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Hasten the day when many will come from east and west, from north and south, and sit at your table in your kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We give you thanks for the whole company of your saints in glory, with whom in fellowship we join our prayers and praises. By your grace, may we, like them, be made perfect in your love. Blessing and glory and wisdom, thanksgiving and honour and power be to our God for ever and ever. Amen.
To crown all things there must be love, to bind all together and complete the whole. Let the peace of Christ rule in our hearts. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace. To you we come, Father of lights, with angels and saints, where heaven and earth unite. May Jesus meet us in the breaking of the bread. Amen. The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should always sing of your glory, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. For you are the hope of the nations, the builder of the city that is to come. Your love made visible in Jesus Christ brings home the lost, restores the sinner, and gives dignity to the despised. In his face your light shines out, flooding life with goodness and truth, gathering into one in your kingdom a divided and broken humanity. Therefore, with all who can give voice in your creation, we glorify your name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Accept our praises, Heavenly Father, through your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, and as we follow his example and obey his command, grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, These gifts of bread and wine may be to us his body and his blood, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Therefore, Heavenly Father, we remember his offering of himself, made once for all upon the cross. We proclaim his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. We look for the coming of your kingdom, and with this bread and this cup, we make the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Lord. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Accept through him, our great high priest, this our sacrifice of thanks and praise. And as we eat and drink these holy gifts, in the presence of your divine majesty, renew us by your Spirit, inspire us with your love, and unite us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honour and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us your peace. Jesus is the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. The body of Christ, keep us in eternal life. Amen. The blood of Christ, keep us in eternal life. Amen. Gracious Lord, in this holy sacrament, you give substance to our hope. Bring us at the last to that fullness of life for which we long. Through Jesus Christ, our Saviour. Amen. We thank you, Lord, that you have fed us in this sacrament, united us with Christ, and given us a foretaste of the heavenly banquet prepared for all peoples. Amen. Our final hymn is Immortal Invisible. And his peace, his light and his joy, in this world and in the next, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be with you and remain with you this day and forever. Amen. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen. Thank you.